Joining us first on NDTV this evening is the Trinamool's Derek O'Brien. Derek, let me first ask you about Mamata Banerjee's strong words. It's after a really long time that we've heard an opposition leader talking about Narendra Modi in 2002. The attack that she made on him directly was particularly sharp.
Beyond the personal, these attacks are not personal. These are facts. And basically what we are looking at, we are putting forth, as Mamata Di did at that massive rally which you mentioned, putting forth as to where this government has failed miserably, be it on economic parameters, be it on social parameters, be it on unity and diversity, be it on jobs, be it on so many things to judge their performance. So if you look at all that, what Mamata Banerjee said on the 21st of July 2018 is something she's been saying from the 8th of November, actually, 2016. 8th of November, 8 o'clock at night, or maybe 8:40 at night, after demonetization was announced. She called it a draconian decision, and she didn't go to Harvard, but she's obviously got this great intuition and understanding of economics and the grassroots, because she did say at that time, and then after that, everyone else saw that she was the first one talking anti-demonetization so strongly. So this has been not suddenly one rainy, wet day in July 2018, but this attack of the BJP government and its policies is what the Trinamool chief and the Trinamool Congress have been outlining for a very long time now.
But you know, Derek, what was also interesting, and I'm sure you noticed this in the Prime Minister's reply to the no confidence motion debate in Parliament on Friday, was that he spent a lot of his time, in fact pretty much his entire speech, attacking the Congress, but he was very soft on the regional parties. He didn't talk about the TMC, he didn't talk about Mayawati, he just sort of, in fact, was trying to give regional parties advice and remind them of everything the Congress had done to them in the past, and in a way telling them, you know, watch out, the Congress isn't a reliable partner. So it's interesting also that I'm sure you would have noticed that he's not sort of burning his bridges with the regional forces.
Please understand, on Friday when the Honorable Prime Minister was making a speech, I'm sure all of you were glued to your seats to watch his speech, but we had this mammoth rally, the 25th year of our Martyrs' Day. We were all very busy doing other things rather than being glued to our seats to watch a 90-minute speech, because we've heard enough of speeches. It's now time for some action, but there's been no action forthcoming. But our position is very, very clear, and we'd like to reiterate that position on our program. Obviously, we will not be fighting elections in many states, but in Bengal, we fancy our chances. The last time we won 34, and we do believe that 42 is within the realms of possibility in Bengal. And we also do believe that even if you're very generous to the BJP and its calculations, and again, it's not something that Trinamool has been saying for the last 1 week, we do believe that anywhere between 100 and 150 is the number which the BJP will be looking at. And nowhere in the Constitution of India, since you're going to ask me the question about the Prime Minister, nowhere does it say that the opposition has to declare its candidate. So we'll cross that bridge. We'll cross that bridge when we come to it. But I would like to say that the people of Bengal and an experienced leader like Mamata Di, who's been 25 years in Parliament, a three-time cabinet minister, a twice-serving chief minister who's come back with this huge record, she's got a lot of experience. And obviously, the way we're looking at things unfolding in the last few weeks and few months, of course she will play a very, very important role.
See, now, what you said is very important, and in fact, it's not the first time you've talked about the kind of experience and the political record that Mamata Banerjee brings to the table. But it's important, Derek O'Brien, that you're saying this a day after the Congress is very clear that they believe that they are a pan-India party that has a footprint across the country, and that if they do emerge as the single largest force, then Rahul Gandhi should be the face of the opposition. What would you say to that? Because as you yourself admit, the TMC is not a pan-India party, right?
Well, when you fight 42 seats in an election like we did last time and you won 34, it depends where you get the runs, you know. It doesn't depend on which stadium you get the runs. You've got to hit the runs, make the runs. And it wouldn't be proper for me to make comments on a political party's working committee meeting. You know, the Trinamool has the working committee meeting and extended committee meetings also once every month and once every 2 months. But it doesn't make the national channels here or the Delhi channels. So it's not proper for me to make comments on the Congress or, for that matter, anybody's own political views and their political
views. So would it be fair to say that you're saying that Rahul Gandhi is not the only one qualified to lead an opposition coalition against Mr. Modi, that it's as much Mamata Banerjee?
That's what you're saying, Nidhi. Who's qualified and who's not qualified is not enough for Trinamool spokespersons or spokespersons from any political party to decide. It's your track record. It's your track record, it's your wide acceptability, and it's the reality of what you're delivering in Bengal. We have delivered in Bengal, and whether it's Bengal, whether it's parliament, whether it's, on policy, if you look at policy, I don't think this is becoming an individual issue. Look at policy. Who was the first person who jumped out, who was first off the blocks? And had, you look at Mamata Banerjee's tweets in the first 48 hours after demonetization. You look at our views on GST. We were all for GST. Our manifesto was for GST for the last 10 years. We had a major issue with the implementation of the GST. So I can go on and on. You look at a program like Kanyashri in Bengal. 50 lakh girls' lives have been touched with a budget of 5,500 crores.
So therefore, you just told us why you think Mamata Banerjee would be a good prime minister.
Let me finish this one point.
Yeah.
One point.
Yeah.
And the same national government with a whole country of 29 states is spending 600-700 crores on a girls' program. You know, so a lot of great work has happened in Bengal. So the cuckoos can come from the BJP and whoever else can make some speeches in Bengal. We are in a very strong position, and Mamata Di has been in the forefront with her experience. But as we want to say in Trinamool, we are like the squirrel in the garden. And the squirrel in the garden is a very effective creature. You can't do without the squirrel in the garden. So we want to play that
Thank
role.
Thank you for that quote.
And we are not greedy for chair one or chair two or chair three. All that comes later. First focus is this country needs people who will deliver, we need university and diversity, and the BJP has to go. And the Congress, the CPIM and the BJP cannot play the different game in Bengal. You know, the Congress also has to make up its mind that you can't have one piece of action in Bengal and one piece of action in Delhi. So the Congress in the Panchayat elections, where the Congress, the CPIM and the BJP got together to take on the Trinamool, and they were unsuccessful.
That's
so
important.
So the Congress is seeking the support of so many of their of the legislation also in Delhi. There has to be some balance with how this works in Bengal.
All right, interesting thoughts there. Squirrel in the garden, the quote that we're going to walk away with. Thank you, Derek O'Brien, for joining us this evening.